Welcome to Wake Up Missoula. My name is Noelle McAvoy.
And I'm Scott Ramp, and we're your hosts to usher you into the new week here in the week of May, the first week in May.
It is
May 2nd, and tomorrow is May 3rd. And why I'm saying May 3rd is because it's our Give Local Day. MCAT's going to be doing a live stream on MCAT. If you go to our website, you just go to MCAT.org, and you can go to our local live tab, which is right about in this general area.
Right about in there.
Yep, you click on it and it shows you a link and you'll be able to watch us live streaming. And we're going to be doing a morning show, a very special morning show tomorrow on Tuesday morning. So you can check us out live online. Of course, you can always check us later in the day by going on to our website, wakeupmissoula.wix.com/wakeupmissoula. So nice, we made you write it out twice. You can also see our postings on our Facebook page, and you can follow us on Twitter to see more recent updates about what's going on with us.
Yeah, you can also follow Wake Up Missoula on Twitter. No, you can follow MCAT on Twitter, at MCATTV Missoula. You can check out Missoula Community Access Television on Facebook, and to find out more information, go to MCAT.org.
Yes, but of course, it is the beginning of the month, which means we're going to start talking about the second Wednesday of the month, which, if you're interested, every second Wednesday of the month, MCAT hosts an orientation where you can come down and you can check out equipment, learn about MCAT, learn about how you can make your own program here on MCAT, channel 189.
Yes, you can make your own show just like us.
But let's talk a little bit about weather. The weather is looking much nicer this week. Next couple days are going to be really nice, they say. And then, of course, Thursday, there's a 50% chance of rain. But, of course, we don't have to worry about that for the next couple days because it's going to be a high of 74 degrees outside. It's going to be sunny, nice and warm. It's been cold the last couple of days for sure, with rainy and cloudy. So that's probably why it's so cold this morning, because we never really got a chance to have a warm
yesterday was nice.
Yesterday was pretty nice.
It
usually takes a while. It usually takes a couple clear, really nice, long days with the sun for us to keep the heat.
It's very true. Yeah. Keep the heat, beat the heat. Yeah. But Scott, so what can you tell us? What is Give Local? You keep talking about this thing, Give Local. What is
it? I'll tell you all about it. So Give Local is an annual event that happens not only in Missoula but kind of all over. And what Missoula's doing in particular is because we're a land of the nonprofits, and Missoula pretty much has more nonprofits than people.
Yes.
And which of course it does not match up to how many dogs we have per people.
It's one nonprofit per person.
Yes. So the idea behind this is that they said, hey, why don't we just get a coalition of nonprofits together and see if they could all help each other raise money. So if you have a nonprofit of your choice, you can go to, I think it's givelocalmissoula.org, and it'll show you this nice little page. Of course, get that giving feeling on May 3rd.
Oh, that was really awkwardly worded. Get that giving feeling,
So you can sign up to volunteer. These are the open hours. Of course, these are the donor lounges. So, of course, anytime tomorrow during the day, you can go to Plonk, Missoula Fresh Market, Missoula Fresh Market again. It's both fresh markets.
I have more information about that stuff when it comes to events.
Yeah.
So I'll tell you more
They're all over the place. They're all over town. Couple grocery stores are definitely doing it, and their major sponsor is First Interstate Bank. It's Missoula. It's First Interstate Bank.
And then Missoula, supported by Federal Credit Union. And the First Interstate Bank, and then the Good Food Store, and then Missoula Community Foundation.
Yeah,
all those.
Yeah.
You can look on that website. Give Local.
Givelocalmissoula.org. Because you want to donate to all the Missoula nonprofits, and you don't want to accidentally give it to Bozeman.
Yeah, ew.
Yeah, because I'm sure they have like two donors who are just like, here's a couple million dollars.
There's
more.
But they're trying to raise $300,000 in combined with 130 different nonprofits that are going to be represented. So, give back to your community. So it starts at, I do believe that it starts at midnight.
Yeah.
So midnight tonight until midnight Tuesday night. All day.
But we do have a bunch of new programming happening tonight.
Oh, good.
It is Right In at Work. It's apparently an ongoing series that just kind of up and started. We have the Missoula Dems, their monthly meeting. Mm-hmm. And of course, we have Working in the Mill, the story about the smoke jumpers based out of Missoula and Bonner area. So they do old Bonner lectures and stuff like that. And one of the speakers is a old smoke jumper from 1954.
Oh, wow. Cool.
So a little bit of history. And then when we come back, we'll have Monday events. But these are all Monday programs. But of course, I have Tuesday programs later in the show. But we'll get to that when we get to talking about Tuesday, which we will after Monday events after this.
I did think of one more thing, which is, you know, sometimes when you're in the publishing process and publishers, you know, really want to own the cover for the most part. And the cover may not be, the author's dream cover.
Yeah.
And it's one of the biggest sales tools, you know, that a publisher has. And even in the age of internet, you know, retailing, it's still something that's there that represents and it does its job.
Probation and parole violators, you know, sent there, and because the jail is too crowded, it concerns them too. So I found them to be pretty good partners in trying to work on this.
And I'll add that the city prosecutors and the county prosecutors, some of the recommendations came from them, like at the city level, the idea to do. Because of course failure to appear, you know, is a huge driver, and it, you know, it's a silly thing to go to jail over. And so
I'm Roger Savage. I jumped out of Missoula for 8 years between 1957 and 1966, and like a lot of jumpers, we kind of gravitated towards aviation, having been around the smoke jumper organization. And I ended up flying in the service. And then I came back to Montana. I was in the Montana Guard flying for them.
That's pretty cool. Nice. Mm-hmm. I bet that's really neat. So what, channel 189 at what time?
They're all happening at different times, but of course, it all kind of starts this afternoon at 4.
Awesome.
And then tonight, you can start watching them at 7 and 8 o'clock.
7 and 8. Great, cool, nice. I will. I have homework. Okay, so how's it going, you guys? Today, this is what's going on in your event. So this is what's happening during Monday. Starting at 11 a.m. over at the Missoula Public Library, they've got their open hours in the makerspace. That's from 11 to 2:30. You can work on a project of your choice or learn how to use their equipment. Preschool playgroup is also happening at 11 over at Roots Acro Sports Center. It's for ages walking to 5 years. They set up different activities and stations around the gym, and the parents and children get to rotate and choose what they want to do. Moscow Monday is at the Montana Distillery. This is every Monday. $1 from each cocktail sold goes to a different nonprofit in the Missoula area. Over at the Lifelong Learning Center is Lunchbox Special Total Body Conditioning. That starts at noon, and it's a body strength and conditioning class. I'm sure it'll be pretty intense. So over at the Holiday Inn downtown, this is kind of interesting. It's a Montana Manufacturing and Trade Day Symposium. So that starts at noon. And the U.S. Commercial Service Montana is partnering with Montana Chamber of Commerce to recognize Montana exporters and provide an afternoon of panels and speakers to help new and experienced exporters succeed internationally. That's kind of interesting. So Governor Bullock will present, have a presentation of the 2015 Exporter of the Year Award. And then an Export Opportunities panel will feature local experts who can assist Montana businesses, as well as some guy named Carrie Hester, who's Director of U.S. Commercial Services in Montana. Wow, you guys, it's just getting better and better. Okay, and then there's a networking reception. This sounds good. So if you manufacture stuff and are looking to get it out there internationally, this is the place for you. It is Craft Beer Week in Missoula, and so at the Rhino, starting at noon, there is a Montana Beer Blind Tasting. $7 for a flight of 4 7-ounce Montana-made beers. Wordplay is at the base at the Warehouse Mall at 4 p.m. This is every Monday. And then also every Monday at the Top Hat Lounge at 5 is Raising the Dead. It's the live recorded shows of the Grateful Dead from the 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s. They play happy hour and trivia and, videos. Over with the Zootown Arts Community Center. They've got a relief printing for beginners class. This is a 5-week class. It's about $65 per person. None of the materials are provided, though, so you have to be responsible for everything. And it starts at 6 o'clock. Also at 6 o'clock over at the Missoula Public Library, they've got computer fundamentals. So if you have a computer but have no idea how to use it, you don't even know how to turn it on, you can call 721-2665 and go to this class and they'll teach you. Over at the Lifelong Learning Center, they have Bicycle Maintenance 101 at 6:30. And then at the Red Bird Wine Bar at 7 is some jazz. It's called the Absent Wilson Conspiracy. And then at the Badlander at 9 is Blues Monday. So that's what's going on in your community for events. Up next, we're switching gears and we're going over to Asaph's segment.
If I were to make a review of Wake Up Missoula, or a review of Scott, or a review of Noelle,
A+,
I'd give Wake Up Missoula and both of you 2 thumbs up.
Aw, thanks, Asaph.
Nice, thanks, Asaph.
Widely known for the thumbs up, thumb down review summaries given, it was Eugene Cal Cisco, known to the world as Gene Cisco, film critic of the Chicago Tribune, and Roger Joseph Ebert, known to the world as Roger Ebert. You can see them on the screen. Roger Ebert is the one on the right. Roger Ebert, known to the world, and he's the film critic of the Chicago Sun-Times. Now, during its run, the television series At the Movies, it was nominated for Primetime Emmy Award 7 times, this show. And it was also nominated for Outstanding Information Series during its run. And there they are again. Now, let me tell you a few things about this show, and then we'll show that clip. Here it is in my notes. The name of the program is called At the Movies. Its original name was called Siskel and Ebert and the Movies, and they eventually changed it to At the Movies to make it easier. At the Movies was a movie review television program produced by Disney ABC Domestic Television, in which 2 film critics would share their opinions of newly released films. There they are again. And those were the hosts, Roger Ebert, Gene Siskel, and they had a program called Sneak Previews on PBS in 1975 to 1982. And then from 1986 to 1987, that's when it became known as Siskel and Ebert at the Movies. Now let's show that film clip and we can catch these two in action.
The other thing is chase pictures. These are chase pictures and they're very well crafted. A lot happens along the chase. We shift locales from land to sea and we get different villains along the way. The big bad guy has lots of henchmen. The third thing, and it's why any product lasts so well for a long time, why you buy the same dishwashing liquid year after year, it's because of quality control. And you know in the Bond films that you're going to get good-looking stunts, good-looking women, and a great-looking Bond. And that's that quality control is very important.
I think there's one thing you're leaving out and that's the gimmick.
Right.
I remember one of the very early Bond pictures. Remember that Aston Martin that he had?
Yeah.
And he knew
DB5,
that if he pushed that button, you know, that the other seat would eject.
Right.
Well, what they've done in all the pictures is they have the scene right at the beginning where they set off what I would call, or where they plant depth bombs, in a sense, or time bombs, because these toys are demonstrated to Bond, and we know that half an hour later, or an hour later, or an hour and a half later, he's going to pull out that magic cigarette lighter and wipe the villain out.
Segment here, they're debating who's the best Bond. Sean Connery or Roger Moore. And they both chose Sean Connery, so that was pretty cool, which I think Sean Connery is the best Bond, but everybody has their preference. Now, these two guys, they had notable divergent taste, and as a result, they would have heated discussions, heated spats and arguments, which made the show more popular. Now, there they are with the Muppets here, and their fights were the highlight of the program. But when they would make appearances like on Letterman, as we see here, actually they were friends in real life and they respected each other and they had a mutual respect and friendship off screen. But on screen, they would tear into each other if they didn't agree. Like, for example, when they were talking about James Bond, the one on the left, he was talking about how Sean Connery is the best Bond, and he tells Roger Ebert, if you don't agree with me, I'm going to throw you over the balcony and step on your head. So those were just little fun little spats that they had. But these two left a great legacy, and then of course they had some health issues as time went by. and the series eventually folded. So that's kind of a flyover of the history of At the Movies. And of course, this program doesn't come on anymore, obviously, because we lost them both a few years back. Mm. So it was just fun. And of course, I give this show thumbs up anyway, nice. Even though these guys are gone. So that's how I'm going to quit. I'm going to stop with my thumbs up.
Thanks, Asaph.
Sure.
That was Musical Notes with Asaph Adam Knight.
And when we come back after these Tuesday programs happening tomorrow night on MCAT.
In the first book, Monkey Bridge, who's claimed to be the most and the pioneer Asian American novel of the Vietnam War, and is widely taught in the U.S., I have a problem with this book. In this book, the author is very clear when she portrayed the Americans. She said that when the Americans came to my village, they bring in soaps, candies, machines to help the farmers, to help the families. They bring in, you know, all these wonderful things about the U.S.
I don't know who was all here last Thursday. I gave a presentation on the federal earned income tax credit. And so I work with an organization in Helena. We're a nonprofit. We do research on tax and budget issues. But one of the things we work on is the federal earned income tax credit. We're also pushing for a state earned income tax credit. In terms of, I'm trying to get a sense of, if I should give a little bit of background in terms of what the federal credit is. I can definitely answer, you know, in terms of your question about like political solutions.
What you can see is the demographics in our population are changing and we're aging. We are so far behind the curve that it is a necessary evil, as it were, perhaps. You need to do 1,000 cataracts in 3 days just to even stay ahead of the game. And it's going to take you 15 years or 20 years to build a true self-sustaining program.
Hello, you guys. We are back. I've got events for tomorrow. So, as tomorrow is Give Local, and that is a huge thing in Missoula, and really, you know, you can really give back to our nonprofits that do a lot for us in Missoula, the citizens. So these are the events that are associated with all the Give Local donors. Or not donors, but like sponsors, you know, Give Local hosts. So over at Missoula Fresh Market, it's from 6 to 11, are snacks and free sandwiches to donors. Wow, that's great. So there's one on Broadway Street, and then the other one is on the other side of town off of Reserve Street. The next one is over at Free Cycles. It's from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. They have snacks, a bike tube patch kit, and free bike repair to the first 24 donors. Yeah, and you know, they're trying to raise money to buy the land that they're on. Yeah, buy the land that they're on. And so that's going to take, I don't know how much money they have, but they still need a lot.
It's going to take a lot.
Yeah. Okay, over the Give Local headquarters, which is over at the Florence building where Scott and I will be, They are having from 8 to 5, they've got snacks, treats from Posh Chocolate, live broadcast, music drawings, philanthropy panel, and photos. Great.
We'll be live from the Florence building pretty much from 8 to 9 for the morning show, and then, of course, 11 to 3 for the afternoon show.
Yep.
And it'll be great. And then, of course, we're going to wrap up the whole Give Local thing at Imagination Brewing Company. Of course, you can probably get to that.
This evening. Oh, I don't have an
It's not
it wasn't
not,
mentioned on there.
It wasn't even mentioned on the Zoo events at 6 o'clock.
Yeah, so tell us about that, Scott.
So at 6 o'clock tomorrow, May 3rd, Imagination Brewing Company is going to host the end of the Give Local party. Everyone gets to hang out, hoist a pint, and just enjoy some music from Kathy Wazowski, as I call her. Wiskowski.
Great. Yeah. That sounds fun. Yeah. And so we'll just wrap up all the events there, and hopefully everyone will have lots of money. Yeah. All right. Well, over at Rose Hours, they've got a Give Local Missoula benefit. This starts at 8 a.m. It's from 8 to 1. It's free coffee, donut or fruit, and donors will be entered to win a drawing of a $200 gift card. It's pretty good. Over the Missoula Senior Center, from 8 to 4 is free lunch, and then 11:30 to 12:30. Okay, no. Yeah, they're open from 8 to 4. Free lunch, 11:30 to 12:30. Bingo, 12:45 to 3. Nice. Over at Opportunity Resources, from 8:30 to 5, they'll have snacks and discount on framed art and pottery by artists of opportunity. Over at the Missoula Federal Credit Union, all branches from 9 to noon, there's going to be free local coffee, and also you can redeem buzz points. I don't know what that means. At the Red Cross Mobile Unit in front of the Florence Building, you can, from 10 to 3, you can enjoy snacks for blood donors. You can give blood, free ice cream, no, it's an ice cream gift card. Wow, they want money and blood from you over there, so they want blood money.
Yeah. Oh,
they want blood money, yeah.
Blood money.
Be careful, yes.
They take your blood and they sell it to hemophiliacs, I don't know.
Stay away from my blood. Okay.
Yeah.
Over at the carousel for Missoula, from 11 to 5:30 is one free carousel ride. Awesome. At the Historical Museum at Fort Missoula from 11 to 1, they have a Celebrate Community, Culture, and Cute Companions.
Aww.
So they have raffle prizes, discount food, animal petting.
Yeah, because the Humane Society is going to be there all day at the Historic.
Oh, fine.
I mean, like, not all day, but, you know, at a reasonable amount of time. There are going to be puppies and and they hope to get people to come down and adopt some of their pets from the Humane Society.
There's going
to
be an adopt-a-thon. That's
or
great.
You're killing puppies if you don't go. Puppies are
go.
Cute. And if you don't go, you'll kill them. It's just as bad as killing puppies.
Literally.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got through that together.
But yeah, adopt-a-thon, carnivals, vouchers. I don't know. Sneak peek of historicals, the Missoula Historical Museum's new exhibit. And they have an old-fashioned photo booth, which that could be kind of fun. Yeah. Okay, we just have a couple more. So over at Home Resource, from 11 to 2, they have coffees and cookies. They've got a coaster for the first 40 donors, and then they have a quiz on zero waste. I don't want a quiz. Okay, over at the Clay Studio in Missoula from 1:30 to 5 is a free drop-in planter making workshop. It's one planter per person per donation. Limit 3 planters per person. Over at Imagination Brewing Company from 2 to 8 is the first drink is free. That's the first 50 donors. And then from 6 to 8 is the snacks and home stretch celebration variety show where we will be wrapping up over there.
So did you hear that? The first 50 donors get free drinks from Imagination Brewing Company.
Wow.
It's ridiculous. When they hear the word free drink, it's like, well,
run!
Boing.
Free drinks! Nice gun.
I've been practicing that for 5 years and finally get to use it.
You did a good job. Okay, over at Plonk from 5 to 6, you can get a free GFC cocktail with each donation and a happy hour specials. Nice. And then at my last event over at Mask Studio on Shakespeare Street over in the west side, they've got an aerial performance from 8 to 10 and wine, snacks, and a drawing.
The Mask Theater. Yeah.
So if you guys want to find out more information about Give Local, just go to givelocalmissoula.com or is it .org?
.org.
givelocalmissoula.org. If you guys want to find out more information about any events I've talked about, just go to missoulaevents.net. The University of Montana's website also has events, as well as the Independent and the Missoulian.
So for this weekend, we did our stop animation drop-in, and we're winding down for the end of the year type of thing. So we only have our stop animation drop-in for another, like,
2 weeks.
Two official weeks with a nice little party for the parents and, of course, DVDs of all the footage and whatnot. But, of course, I got a chance to go to the Ronald McDonald Kids Fair that was happening at the Valentine Center, which is the indoor soccer arena, which is surprising because I didn't know Missoula had an indoor soccer arena in the first place. But, of course, I went there. I did it, and I just kind of hung out, and then I did a little stop animation in the meantime.
Nice.
So check it out.
Drop.
that was adorable.
That was adorable.
You did such a good job. How was that? How was that?
It was long, and we got some kids to sit down. And the funny thing about stop animation is, like, when a kid gets in stop animation, and they don't stop. It keeps their attention for hours.
Yes, it does.
Yep. Some kids are, like, really into it. Some kids, like, even if, like, the most, like, ADHD kid is, like, into it for, like, at least an hour and a half tops before they're just like, oh, you can't do this anymore.
It's true. Yeah. They tend to lose their attention span after about 2 hours, we decided. I decided that this morning.
You decided that this
morning. I did. I told Scott, and he was like, It was literally like that.
But of course, you know, stop animation is fun sometimes.
It is fun.
It's a good time waster for sure. It's very tedious, but definitely a good time waster if you're just kind of hanging out. It only took me like a couple minutes to set up. But, I just do want to show some social networking before we go. But of course, I have a nice little picture of myself at Ronald McDonald House. They give me a nice shirt, and this is me pointing towards the future.
Who took a picture of you?
Random. Our neighbors did.
Oh, nice.
Thanks, neighbor.
Thanks, neighbor.
But of course, if you want to be our neighbor and you want to come down to MCAT anytime, just come into 500 North Higgins, Suite 105, and learn more about us. Our open hours are between 1 and 8, Tuesday through Friday, with an exception on Friday, which is we close at 7. So, it's Friday. Come on, we want to party.
Yeah.
So, of course, if you want to party with us, log on to wakeupmissoula.wix.com/wakeupmissoula. So nice to meet you right out to us. You can like us on Facebook. You can follow us on Twitter at Wake Up Missoula.
You can follow MCAT on Twitter at MCAT TV Missoula. You can like Missoula Community Access Television on Facebook. And to find out more information about us, go to MCAT.org.
Yes, and our orientation is a week from this Wednesday, which is 9 days from this particular day. Nine days and about 6 hours, 6.5 hours or so, or 6 hours exactly.
Yeah, and so you guys be sure to tune in for Wake Up Missoula tomorrow. We'll be at the Florence Building for Give Local. But we will be canceled on Wednesday.
Yes. But if you want to watch us again, you can always find us on YouTube. We have over 400 videos of our Wake Up Missoula fabulousness.
Yes.
So without further ado, I want to say thanks, you guys, for joining me on this nice Monday. It's a nice short show, nice easygoing. Everything's going to be pretty light today, but tomorrow is Give Local. So check all that stuff out starting tomorrow at 8 a.m.
So for Wake Up Missoula, my name is Noelle McFoy.
And I'm Scott Ramp.
Here's Asaph Adonai.